For over five decades, a list of bizarre similarities about the life and death of these two presidents, Abraham Lincoln and John F. Kennedy, still finds its way to the web. And with all the reposting of the supposed new versions, this post is likely to stick around. So Project Debunk made an effort to revisit the facts surrounding the issue and to make a striking doubt on this controversy and to settle a more serious question regarding this issue. Why do we always end up associating random events into a similar pattern? Is this practice just random, or it goes something deeper to the core of our human nature? Keep watching to know the truth about it. First, for those who haven't heard, let's reveal what is this so-called list of Lincoln and Kennedy coincidence all about. Just chill, let me do the job.
Space is open to us now, and our eagerness to share its meaning is not governed by the efforts of others. We go into space because whatever mankind must undertake, free men must fully share.
Here are some of the facts noted to constitute the supposed similarities. Some of this centers around the fact that many of the interesting incidents occurred 100 years apart. So let's start. Abraham Lincoln was elected to Congress 1846. John F. Kennedy was elected to Congress 1946. Abraham Lincoln was elected president in 1860, whereas John F. Kennedy was elected president in 1960. They were both particularly concerned with civil rights. Their wives both lost a child while living in the White House. Abraham Lincoln was shot on the head on Friday, while John F. Kennedy was shot on the head on Friday. Well, that's weird, right? Here's more. Lincoln's secretary was named Kennedy, and Kennedy's secretary was named Lincoln. Both presidents were assassinated by Southerners and were succeeded by Southerners named Johnson. Andrew Johnson, who succeeded Lincoln, was born in 1808. Lyndon Johnson, who succeeded Kennedy, was born in 1908. John Wilkes Booth, who murdered Lincoln, was born 1839, and Lee Harvey Oswald, who assassinated Kennedy, was born in 1939. These two assassins were known by their three names, and their names were composed of 15 letters. Now, that's cringy. Here's another. Lincoln was shot at a theater named Ford. Kennedy was shot in a car called Lincoln, made by Ford. The assassins, Booth and Oswald, were assassinated before their trials. Mind-blowing, right? You can handle it. Here's more. A week before Lincoln was shot, he was in Monroe, Maryland. And a week before Kennedy was shot, he was with Marilyn Monroe. Finally, when Lincoln was shot in the theater, the assassin, John Wilkes Booth, ran into a warehouse. On the other hand, when Kennedy was shot from a warehouse, the assassin ran into the theater. So, there goes the list of the coincidence. While the coincidences are weird and flat out cringy, some of the enumerated similarities are not actually true and were immediately debunked. First, although President Kennedy did have a female secretary named Evelyn Lincoln, there is no record showing that President Lincoln actually had a secretary named Kennedy. Instead, fact checkers noted that John G. Nicolay and Jan Hay were the Lincoln's White House secretaries. Second, the assassins were not born in the same year. John Booth was born May 10, 1838, while Lee Harvey Oswald was born October 18, 1939. Third, Oswald fled from warehouse where he shot Kennedy and was arrested in a movie theater, while Booth ran from Ford's theater where he shot Lincoln. He was caught, however, in a barn. And probably the most outrageous claim in the list was when Kennedy was with Marilyn Monroe a week before he was shot. Why? Because Marilyn Monroe died for over a year before Kennedy's assassination. Of course, you have probably read about this, but the more intriguing question is, why do we have this tendency of trying to relate two distinct stories into a definitive pattern? Is there any rational explanation to this practice? One definite answer to this mystery was the psychological phenomenon known as apophenia, where we tend to combine random data hoping to yield some relevant patterns. This practice is not necessarily a negative trait. A psychologist, Jan Cohen, also explained that nothing is so alien to the human mind as the idea of randomness. We need to make sense of extremely random things to give us a sense of comfort. In this case, the sudden, shocking and senseless loss of the two of the nation's most influential leaders may somehow give us a sense of comfort by drawing a connection between them, hoping to come up a more relevant and sensible pattern. Not only does this trait aim to make sense of the world, it also serves as a safety tool. Seeing and making assumption about patterns relates to our self-preservation tendencies. It's necessary for survival, because without apophenia, we become just a horde of unquestioning and ignorant creatures following a patternless existence where everything just simply pop up without reason. Without this, we are deprived from learning from human experiences. Apophenia is a psychological tool we can use to embody a more sensible and safer environment, the tool that would lead to a rationalization that this happened before, so I must be careful. However, once taken out of context, things may likely result into the perpetuation of Lincoln-Kennedy coincidence and other weird conspiracy theories to make sense of the frightening random chaos and tragedy to give a sense of comfort and security in the face of randomness. If you finish watching this video, I'd like you to know that I really value your love and kindness. Click the next video to know more about this viral Twitter guy who was claimed to have predicted coronavirus 7 years ago.